हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट पेपर नंबर 4, दैट इज माइक्रोबियल फिजियोलॉजी। एंड इन दिस पेपर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट हियर दैट फर्स्ट यूनिट, दैट इज बैक्टीरियल कल्टीवेशन एंड मेंटेनेंस। एंड इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल सी हियर अबाउट द कल्टीवेशन ऑफ बैक्टीरिया। बिफोर दैट I want to tell you one important thing, that if you have not subscribed this Microbiology by Santosh Napte, so kindly subscribe this YouTube channel so that you will get notifications of upcoming videos. So all of you know that microbiology, it is a very important, and therefore when if you want to study this microbiology, at that time it will require a basic thing, that is these bacteria or these microorganisms. So to study these microorganisms or these bacteria, it is very essential to grow these bacteria in laboratory or in your research institute. So growing of these bacteria in laboratory, simply this is nothing but the cultivation or culturing of bacteria. So in this topic we will see about the different types of media, then we will see about the types of media, then we will also see about the how these bacteria can be cultivated, or how these bacteria can be cultured by using different techniques. That is how we can obtain these bacteria in a pure form, that is pure culture techniques. So let's start this very important topic in microbiology, that is cultivation of bacteria. So what is meant by this cultivation or culturing of bacteria? So microbial culture or cultivation or culturing of bacteria, it is a method of multiplying microorganisms by letting them reproduce in a predetermined culture media under controlled laboratory conditions. So whatever that laboratory conditions are required for the growing or multiplication of microorganisms, these conditions are under control, and these particular microorganisms, it is grown on the nutrient medium, allowing them to reproduce or allowing them to multiply. So simply growing of this microbial culture in a predetermined culture media under controlled laboratory conditions, that is called as cultivation or culturing of bacteria. And these microbial cultures which are cultivated or cultured on a laboratory media, these microbial cultures later on use to determine the type of organisms, its abundance in the sample which is to be tested, or sometimes there is both purposes are there, that is to determine the type of organisms and its abundance in the sample which is to be tested. So why we are going to culture these microorganisms? What is the purpose behind this culturing of microorganisms? So the first purpose is isolation of bacteria, because whatever that microorganisms are present in the nature, they are not present in pure form, that is they are present in the mixed form, or these are mixed cultures. So first you have to isolate that bacteria, and this is our first purpose of culturing microorganisms. Second purpose is to study the properties of bacteria. That is culturing bacteria, it is the initial step during the study of microorganisms, which includes study of morphology of that microorganisms as well as its identification. Morphology means here how that microorganisms looks, whether these are rod shaped, whether these are spherical, that is, or whether these are bacillus or cocci respectively, and then later on this culturing also includes its identification. It means whether it is E. coli, whether it is Salmonella, or whether it is that specific type of microorganisms. Then next purpose is maintenance of stock cultures. Because if you consider the industrial microbiology, then there is a requirement of that cultures which are used to produce the desired product. But on the 11th hour, we are not going to isolate that microorganisms from the mixed culture and then we will use that culture for the production. That is not the case. So that cultures are maintained in the laboratory. So there is a stock of that pure cultures in industrial or for industrial purposes. So this is also the one purpose of culturing microorganisms, that is maintenance of stock cultures. Then to estimate the viable counts. Next purpose is to test for antibiotic sensitivity, because there are large number of antibiotics are available in market or in the medicals and that are used for the treatment of different diseases. But before using that antibiotic for the treatment of diseases, there is a testing is done on that particular antibiotic, that is which microorganisms are sensitive to that antibiotic. So that is to test for antibiotic sensitivity. Then to create antigens for laboratory use. So there is a preparation of antigens are also there from these bacteria, and that is specifically for the study or for laboratory use. Then next purpose is certain genetic studies and manipulations of the cells also need that particular bacteria to be cultured in vitro. And next purpose of culturing bacteria is, so this culturing on solid media, it is the another convenient way of separating bacteria from a mixture. So if you want to isolate that bacteria in a pure form or pure culture, then you have to first culture that bacteria in laboratory, or you have to cultivate that bacteria in laboratory, then it is possible to isolate that bacteria in a pure form from the mixed culture. So all these are the purposes of culturing or cultivating of microorganisms. So when you are going to cultivate or culture these microorganisms in the laboratory, then you will require a specific nutrient media to use for the culturing of bacteria, and simply that media is called as culture media. So what is this culture media, or it is also called as the medium. Medium, it is the singular number, media is the plural number. So an artificial culture media, it must provide similar environmental and nutritional conditions that exist in the natural habitat of a bacterium. So when that bacteria grows in a natural habitat, so whatever that conditions are available in that natural habitat, same conditions must be provided by the culture media. So that may be related to the environmental conditions, or that may be nutritional conditions. So you have to design such media, then it is called as the artificial culture media, and that must provide all these conditions which are similar, environmental as well as nutritional conditions, which are exactly similar to the natural habitat of that bacterium. And this culture medium, it consists of water, it must consist of a source of carbon as well as energy, then it consists of source of nitrogen, trace elements and some growth factors. So when you are preparing that culture media or nutrient media in a laboratory, that is when you are preparing artificial culture media, so that media must contains water, it must contains sources of carbon and energy, it must contain source of nitrogen, trace elements as well as growth factors, so that when you will grow that microorganisms on this culture medium, so they can grow very rapidly, because all nutrients get available to these microorganisms. And the pH of the medium, it must be set accordingly or according to that particular organisms. So when the proper pH is available, then that microorganisms will grow properly. So what are the uses of this culture media? That includes enriching of the number of bacteria, then select for certain bacteria and suppress others, that is they do not allow to grow unwanted microorganisms. That means that nutrient media suppresses the growth of others, but they allow the growth of only selected bacteria. then that culture media differentiate among different kinds of bacteria. So they can differentiate that bacteria into different types. So these are the uses of culture media. So next point is here, pure culture. So what is this pure culture? Pure means it does not consist of any other bacteria. It consists of only one type. That means it is pure. So in the laboratory, these bacteria, they are isolated and they are grown in a pure culture in order to study the functions of a particular species. If you want to study that particular organism or bacteria, then that bacteria which is to be studied, it must be available in a pure form. So there should not be presence of another microorganisms or another bacteria. So this only one type of bacteria, it is called as the pure culture. And this pure culture, it is a population of cells or growing in the absence of other species or types. So there is a presence of only one type of bacteria or that species, and it does not growing in presence of other species. Instead, it is growing in the absence of other species or types. And this pure culture, it may originate from a single cell or a single organism, in which case the cells are genetic clones of one another. It means all types of microorganisms, they are similar or they are of the same genetic clones, and it does not consist of any other type of organism, then we can say it is a pure culture. So how these pure cultures are obtained? So these pure cultures are obtained by using a different types of techniques, which we are going to see in later. So all glassware which are used for obtaining these pure cultures, that may be glassware, that may be nutritional media, or that may be instruments. So that media, glassware or instruments must be sterilized. That is, there is a use of, or there should be use of aseptic techniques to obtain these pure cultures. And the basic requirement for obtaining of these pure cultures, that includes solid medium, then a media container that can be maintained in an aseptic condition, and a specific technique which is to be used for the separation of these individual cell. Then this single bacterium, which is later on supplied with the proper nutrients, will multiply on that solid nutrient medium or a limited area, and after 24 hours of incubation period, it will form a colony. This colony, it is a mass of large number of cells, and all these cells, these are descended from the original one cell. So initially there is a one cell will be there, and from this single cell, many cells will be formed, or mass of large number of cells will be formed, which is called as colony. Then this is a very important material, we can say, or component of nutrient medium, that is called as agar simply, or it is also called as agar agar. So this agar or agar agar, it is a solidifying agent. Actually, it does not provide any nutrient, but it is a solidifying agent. That means it is necessary to make that particular nutrient medium like a gel or solid. And this agar, it is a polysaccharide in nature, and it is extracted from the marine algae, which is used to solidify a specific nutrient solution. So if you want to make that liquid medium, if you want to convert that liquid medium into solid medium, then you have to add this agar agar powder. So that's why this agar, it is called as solidifying agent. And unlike other gelling agent, it is not easily degraded by bacteria. Then it is not easily destroyed at higher temperatures, and therefore it can be sterilized by using heating process. And once this medium, after addition of agar, gets solidified, this now agar medium will remain solid until you melt it. Then the culture media, it is contained in a petri dish or petri plate, then two part, that is glass or the plastic covered container. Now the next point we will see about the classification of culture media. How these culture media are classified, because there are different types of nutritional media or culturing media, and this bacterial culture media, that can be classified by three different ways. First one, according to the consistency. Second one, according to the nutritional component. And third one, according to the functional use. So by three different ways, we can classify that culture media: consistency, nutritional component, and functional use. One by one, we will see here. The first one, classification of new culture media according to consistency. And according to this consistency, that nutrient or culture media, these are of three different types. One is liquid media, second one is solid media, and third one is semi-solid media. So we will see in detail classification based on consistency. The first one, liquid media. So as the name suggests, these culturing media, these are liquid in nature, and these are available for use in test tubes, bottles, or flasks. And these liquid media, these are generally called as broths. For example, nutrient broth. So when there is a broth is coming in the name of that nutrient media, it indicates that nutrient media is a liquid media. For example, nutrient broth, it means this nutrient broth, it is a liquid media. If you are saying McConkie's broth, it means that McConkie's broth is a liquid media. So that broth indicates that medium is liquid medium. And in liquid medium, that bacteria, they grow uniformly producing general turbidity. So when you are growing that liquid microorganisms or bacteria in a nutrient broth, for example in test tubes, after 24 hours of incubation, when there is a growth of that bacteria will take place. So that can be indicated just by observing that particular test tubes. If that test tubes containing that nutrient media become more turbid, it indicates there is a more growth of bacteria takes place. So that turbidity, it indicates growth of bacteria. And no agar is added, because that agar is a solidifying agent. So we are not adding that agar in this liquid media, that's why it is remaining liquid. And mostly it is useful for the preparation of inoculum. Then second type of media is solid media. So an agar plate or a petri dish that contains a growth medium, which is agar plus nutrients, these are used to culture or grow microorganisms, and generally 2 to 3% of agar is added in a liquid media. When you will add that 2 to 3% agar in a liquid media, so that liquid media get converted to solid. So that's why that agar, it act as a solidifying agent, and it is most commonly used solidifying agent. Then colony morphology, pigmentation, then hemolysis, that can be appreciated. And examples of solid media includes nutrient agar. So when there is a agar is coming in the name of that nutrient media, that indicates that is a solid medium. Here we have seen when broth is coming, it indicates it is a liquid medium. So that nutrient agar, blood agar, McConkie's agar, Salmonella shigella agar, so all these are the solid media. Next one is semi-solid media. So such media, these are fairly soft, and these are useful in demonstrating the motility of bacteria. Motility means here, that is the ability of bacteria to move from one location to another location. Then, and separating motile bacteria from the non-motile. Examples of semi-solid media includes Hughes and Lifson's oxidation fermentation medium. And in this semi-solid media, there is a 0.5% agar is added. In solid media, the percentage of agar is 2 to 3%, and in semi-solid media, it is only 0.5%. And there is a complete absence of agar in liquid media. So this is the solid medium. It is added in petri plate or petri dish. Then this is liquid medium in test tubes, and this is the semi-solid medium here in test tubes. See, these are also the examples of solid, liquid, and semi-solid medium. So this is the solid medium here, added in the petri plate. This is semi-solid medium, and this is liquid medium. Then classification based on nutritional components. So on the basis of nutritional components, these media are also classified. And again, these are of three different types of media on the basis of nutritional components. One is simple medium, second one is complex medium, and third one is synthetic or chemically defined medium. So in short, we will see about that types of nutrient media based on nutritional components. So simple media, It includes such as peptone water, nutrient agar, and they can support most non-fastidious bacteria. Non-fastidious bacteria means here that bacteria, they does not require any special type of nutrients. They can grow in a general media or in a basal media. So these are nothing but the simple media. So that's why these are also called as basal media. Examples includes nutrient broth, nutrient agar. This, if you see the component of this nutrient broth, that consists of peptone, it consists of yeast extract and sodium chloride. And when that 2 to 3% of agar is added to this nutrient broth, so this nutrient broth get, that is a liquid, get converted to solid, and then we can call it as a nutrient agar. Second one is complex media. As the name suggests here, these medias are somewhat complex. So media other than basal media, these are called as complex media, and they have a special components in them which support the growth of microorganisms. And these special ingredients or components, that includes yeast extracts or casein hydrolates, and they consist of a mixture of many chemicals in a unknown proportion, because the quantity of that many chemicals, it is not properly known or it is unknown. Third type of media on the basis of nutritional component, it includes synthetic media, or which is also called as chemically defined media. So these are specially prepared media for research purposes, where the composition of every component of that particular nutrient medium, it is well known. The concentration of each and every component, it is well known, or proportion is well known, and it is prepared from pure chemical substances. For example, peptone water, now it is a synthetic medium or chemically defined medium, and that's why the proportion of this peptone water, it is known, because it consists of 1% peptone and plus it consists of 0.5% sodium chloride or NaCl in water. So this was about the classification based on nutritional components. Next type is here, that is the third criteria for the classification of nutritional media or culturing media, that is on the basis of functional use or application. And according to this criteria, that culturing media are of six different types. One is enriched media, second one is selective media, third one is differential media, fourth one is transport media, fifth one is indicator media, and sixth one is anaerobic media. So this third type we will see in next lecture. If you are not subscribed this microbiology by Santosh Napte, so kindly subscribe this channel and share these videos with your students, with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe this channel. Thank you.